As news broke that all four police officers involved in George Floyd's death have now been charged, tens of thousands of protesters were again hitting the streets.
Say we got all four!
We got all four!
Say we got all four!
We got all four!
The charge against Derek Chauvin, who knelt on Floyd's neck, now upgraded to second-degree murder.
George Floyd mattered. He was loved. His family was important. And we will seek justice for him.
This is a step today that the public wants to see. Our justice system needs to make sure that justice is served.
Arrest is not a conviction, and we want justice. We don't want partial justice, we want whole justice.
Rallies started peacefully, but as temperatures dropped and curfews approached, the atmosphere quickly changed.
I'll get myself up to stop!
Police in New York seen brutally enforcing the 8 p.m. curfew.
Oh, my God.
As widespread looting continues, these scenes from Melrose Drive, L.A.
Right now, I think the nation needs law and order because you have a bad group of people out there.
The president's active military threats are under increasing fire. His former defense chief, James Mattis, saying, Donald Trump is the first president in my lifetime who does not try to unite the American people, does not even pretend to try. Instead, he tries to divide us. No doubt hearing the call, it's former President Barack Obama offering the message of hope so many desperately want to hear.
As tragic as these past few weeks have been, they've also been an incredible opportunity for people to be awakened. There is a change in mindset that's taking place, a greater recognition that we can do better.
For no justice, for no justice.
Now, I want to speak directly to the young men and women of color in this country. I want you to know that you matter. I want you to know that your lives matter.
And we spoke to social activist Kwame Rose in Baltimore earlier. Kwame, what's it been like there over the past 24 hours?
The past 24 hours, I mean, we had a demonstration today. But the past 24 hours, I'd say, have been like the past week. In Baltimore, we are dedicated to keeping the scene calm, tensions from rising. But still allowing protesters and young people to express their pain and outrage about what has happened across the country and in particular in this city.
So how are people there reacting to the news that more officers have been charged over George Floyd's death?
On the ground, I don't think most people know. But understand, we're from Baltimore, right? 5 years ago, six officers were charged in the death of Freddie Gray. And not one of those officers was convicted of anything. So we understand here in Baltimore that charges do not mean conviction, that there's still a long process to justice ahead.
But that is what the protesters have been calling for. If that, I mean, they can't keep protesting, surely, until the trials play out. Do you anticipate that they're going to be staying on the streets anyway?
I can't tell you. What I can tell you is that the way this case has been handled up until this point has been completely wrong. And I think that, in a lot of ways, powers that be still think that we're playing. Without what happened in Minneapolis a few nights ago, there would not have been an arrest of the officer. Without the continuous uprising of Black people and our allies across the country over the last few days, those other four officers or three officers would not be in custody tonight.
Kwame, 5 years ago, you went viral for confronting a Fox News reporter over their coverage of similar riots in your city back in 2015. Has there been a shift in how this is being reported 5 years on?
Yeah, I do notice that there's a lot of coverage, a change in coverage. Again, once again, we saw a Black man die on video at the hands of the police. This time, we watched it for almost 9 minutes. People didn't start paying attention until the burning of a CVS. I think that the media sensationalizes Black people's pain. I think that the media sensationalizes the tactics that the people use when expressing that pain. If the media were talking about the deep-rooted issues in Black communities, if they were talking about how police officers constantly get away with this, if they talked about it without having to be another example, without another Black person having to die, if these were conversations on an everyday basis, we would not be here.
Former President Barack Obama has been pretty quiet throughout Trump's presidency, but today he spoke of the need to review and reduce police violence. And like we just heard before, he spoke to young people of colour saying, your lives matter. How symbolic is it to hear from him right now?
You know, 5 years ago we heard from Barack Obama in Baltimore when he called us thugs and criminals when people ran inside of a CVS. A year after that, I heard from Barack Obama when he personally called me a 22-year-old misguided kid for calling him out for calling us thugs. Listen, Barack Obama was the first person to call protesters thugs in my lifetime. And he, what he did back 5 years ago gave Trump the audacity to say, now we can shoot these thugs. Listen, we're not fighting here for people of color. And I want to be very clear and intentional about that. This movement, this moment, this revolution right now is about Black people. This country was built off of the labor, the slave labor, the free labor of Black people. And for 400 years, Black people haven't been given anything in this country. We're saying right now is enough, and that Barack Obama being the first Black president didn't cure all racism.
But does it feel different this time around? Do you think that this is the point where you're going to see some real change?
Black people don't have the opportunity to hope right now because we see people dying. George Floyd moved to Minneapolis to do the right thing, and he still was killed. We've been through this so many times before, so we know what happens. We know the technicalities when it comes to police getting away with the killing of unarmed Black people. And so I think it is necessary to continuously demonstrate until the judge hits the gavel and sentences these four murderers, or the one murderer and the three accomplices who sat in compliance and silence. And until the judge hits the gavel and sentences them to pay for their crimes.
That could be years away. Do you really think people are going to stay out on the streets every day for years?
You know, if we didn't think that we'd see a revolution like this in our lifetime spark up the way it has. Well, these are unprecedented times. This is the first time in my lifetime that so many places around the world are standing in solidarity for the lives of Black people. I don't think the world's seen anything like this. I do know that we're only at the beginning.
Kwame, on that note, we've seen thousands take to the streets of London in support. There's protests planned this weekend in Australia. Does that level of international support surprise you?
No. I've traveled through Europe. It doesn't. The level of international support doesn't surprise me. All across the world, the lives of melanated people, in particular those of African descent, in particular those who were forced to cross continental waters via the slave trade, those lives have to be given value from powers that be. In the developed world, if we want to call it that, the powers that be just happen to be white. And it's white people on the left and it's white people on the right that need to come together and finally talk to each other and explain why valuing Black life is the solvency to valuing all life. The only way we're going to solve white supremacy is when white people start talking to their cousins, their parents, their friends, their students, whoever, that they come in contact with on an everyday basis about their privilege, how their privilege is dangerous for Black people, and how their silence is complacency with the system that does not value all lives the same across the board.
We just saw there some widespread looting in LA. Does that complicate things at all?
No, it doesn't. It doesn't at all. We've seen videos of white people running into Patagonia. We've seen videos of white folks running and police officers picking up some materials. Not only that, but I think there has been a substantial effort by organizers of protest in Los Angeles to stay away from Black communities. The protests aren't happening anywhere in South LA. They're happening in the neighborhoods and pockets of privilege. And if people want to express their pain in that way, I will not condone it. I will not tell protesters to be peaceful, but I will tell and ask is that police officers remain peaceful because they are the ones creating the violence.
Kwame, we really appreciate you speaking to us. Stay safe, and we hope to catch up with you soon. Thanks for your time tonight.
Oh, thank you. I hope the next time it won't be in the car, but thank you.
It's amazing. It's not ending soon.
It's not. You can sense a hardening, can't you?
Yeah.
Across the area.